let's get this done. Okay, let's see here. What were we doing? Oh yeah, so we're in like an underground train station. And so for all the puzzles here have revolved around trying to move these trains from point A to point B and using them as battering rams to bash through giant fucking gates and stuff. Seems always like clip through the freaking floor when you shoot them. Hey, Dragon Facts. What did that do? So those slugs, for people just tuning in, when they're feeding on something, they'll screw with the electronics, and getting rid of them fixes something. Looks like we've done something here with these displays. Let's hack this computer here and see what happens.
Access denied. Access.
All right, got a open path for our train now.
Disconnecting access denied.
A tough one.
Access denied. Access granted.
Device inoperable. Train recall.
Disconnecting. Disconnecting.
All right.
Recharging.
Follow me.
Okay. So I guess we can just keep riding the train forward now that we've opened it up. I was in. Do I think this would do well with a remake? No. I don't know what a remake would improve, and I don't see today's gamers having the patience to go through playing this either. But I'm not a big fan of remakes in general. Hey, Duke. Hey, Duke. The heck? These stupid little tiny spiders making that noise. Where the hell are they? Oh, they're up there. I played a little bit of the Steam version of it. I didn't play it back when it was new and broken though. Okay, secret entrance to Eden Bunker. Yeah, I was tempted to get it because of D.W. Bradley, and I was a big fan of Wizards and Warriors, the last game he made with that development team, but... Oh god, there's turrets here. Oh, Jesus. Oops. Well, that's not good. Yeah, I've heard the horror stories. From what I played of the Steam version, it's not broken anymore, but it's also not very good. it's an action RPG that gets the action part of action RPG about as wrong as you possibly could. It just feels terrible to play. Am I gonna have to bring the train back every time somebody dies? What the fuck? Is there a spawn point up here? Stream the old broken version. I mean, it certainly fits your your channel's pattern of playing horribly broken games, but I don't know how interesting it would be, because it's the actual like game behind the brokenness is not particularly compelling, you know. Yeah, it's just slow and super clunky action RPG with like awful hit detection where you're just like swinging your sword and it's just whiffing directly through their bodies and doing nothing, and you're just like, oh my god. Disconnecting. Hey, where are you going? Okay, good. I thought it was okay. Yeah, about the only thing from that game that seemed kind of cool was it's got the leveling system basically right out of Wizards and Warriors, which is a system I really enjoyed. So the character development seems like it would be pretty satisfying. But yeah, everything else was just like, oh no.
Follow me.
The enemy AI here. Yeah, no worries, man. It's a game I'd really like to enjoy. Like, I like the...
Follow me.
The structure of the game and the... And the character system. But the combat is so just... Not... just not on. There's probably some way to break it, but the character system being the most polished part about it, it's not that kind of game really. There might be. I didn't delve too deeply into the magic side of things when I played, and I only played it for like 3 or 4 hours. But yeah, there might be something in the magic. Hey Beard, hey Astro Vortex, how you guys doing? Did you Yahoo's follow me? No? Okay, fine. See, for folks who didn't see last time, this crappy gun I'm using creates extra ammo clips, which is why I'm using it. We've been burning through our ammo pretty heavily on this map, so just take this opportunity to refill a bit. It doesn't do a lot of damage, but if you can use it safely, you get free ammo out of it. Oh shit, okay, that's what I was like, what is shooting green energy at me? There's turrets down there. Exploitable invisibility, yeah, maybe. Exactly, what's the benefit of opening an infinitely respawning monster hole? It's not letting me climb in here. Further down here. Oof. Damn. That dealt a lot of damage.
Follow me.
Why are you? Dummy's not moving.
Follow me.
Follow me.
Recharging. Recharging.
Follow me.
Wrong way, wrong way. Okay. Left appears to be broken.
Follow me.
Oh, it came up fine. Hey, Space Princess Saida. Ow.
Recharging.
Noise the little spiders make is so annoying. Hey, RJ, it's going well. Still enjoying the game. Oh, this just comes out down here. Ow. So then what? What's the point of these elevators? What? One of those rare situations in this game where I don't actually know what I'm trying to do. Usually you know exactly what you're attempting to accomplish, it's accomplishing it that's tricky.
Recharging.
I have no idea what it is they even want me to do here. This doesn't make any sense.
Follow me.
Whoops. Okay, so we need to get Minoko up here to use that panel. Well, that's not good. Are you talking about Lost Vikings? Eric the Swift. Oh crap. Oh, we're gonna make it. We're gonna make it. Okay, so those turrets are disabled. That's good. Oh, I didn't see that. Combat in this game leaves a little something to be desired, clearly.
Mm.
Okay. Cool. So now the path is open. We don't have to dig around with these elevators anymore. Where's the... You got the one with the switch.
Follow me.
Yeah. What the fuck?
Follow me.
Follow me.
All right. Backwards. Can we ride the train here? Thought so.
Follow me.
Then wait, what? So we disabled the turrets out here. Is there something in here?
hazardous environment.
Hey, Fake Pickle, yeah, we're finishing this today, one way or the other. Spoken like someone who's never played Rainbow Six. Spiders just everywhere. Insect spray would be helpful. Okay, so we open this up. Ow. I guess it could sort of be considered close to Ghost Recon. Ghost Recon, you could switch between your people. But even then, not a puzzle game. This is a puzzle game, through and through. Out of here. me. Shithead. I've only ever played the demo of Messiah. But MDK, I love MDK. The first one. I thought the sequel was pretty bad, but the shiny MDK was great. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I saw some of Tom's stream of Messiah. Definitely an odd game. But everything Shiny made was really weird. That was kind of Shiny's thing. How can we make this really odd? Yeah, BioWare, not very good at action. As we keep learning as they keep making action games nowadays, but okay. Whoa. What the hell? You have an ignition capacitor, whatever the heck that is. I am so lost right now. This looks like you should be able to climb it. Yes, yeah, this definitely feels very Tomb Raider, this level. The hit point sponge enemies, yeah. And the bad combat. Clearly, we need to get more people over here. Question is, where is here and how do we get here? It's pretty long. We're 20 hours now. All of Core's games were pretty damn long, though. The Tomb Raiders are really long, too. Shit! Ow! This is where this game's awkward running system bites in the ass. You have to build momentum. So I have to sit here and run in a circle so I'm going fast enough to get through.
Follow me.
Thank you. Alright, cool. We got everybody here. Alright. Okay, so somebody has to hold this pump engine down so it's running. I don't know what this engine does exactly, but you sit there and hold that. Now this shit spins. Get up, climb. Climb, climb, climb! Shit's a little of jank. Wait, I need to get here with Andre? What? Can Andre survive the... just like toxic sludge at the bottom of the tank. Ow. No, he can't. Oh god. Oh god. So he has to like walk right onto the bottom one as it turns by, I guess. No, 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 no! Oh, Jesus. Fuck.
No trouble.
So what did that, turning that on, like, repairing that anyway, what did that fix? What did we just do? Did we do something with this drain tank thing? that's going up and down like crazy. Just need to go further this way and see if something's changed. Maze of pipes. Where is this all headed? This comes back here. Okay, I'm going backwards. Shit. Go away. To hear that spider noise for the rest of my life. It'll be too goddamn soon. Worst noise ever. Hey, horrible stream. This doesn't go anywhere, okay. So, why did we do this? Oh, the tank's like empty. Oh, there's a door down there. This looks suicidal. Oh god. Duck. Oh god. Hey Dominus, how you doing? Yay! Okay. Good. Now we know what the point of that was. Oh, and we can let go of the engine and then, and then it stops trying to cut you in half. Durr.
I need some assistance.
Herp derp derp. Okay.
Follow me.
Okay, what's next? It's like Minoko's up.
Downloading data. Access denied. Access denied.
A tough one.
Access denied.
Oh, come on.
Access denied.
What?
Access granted. Disconnecting. Disconnecting.
I need some assistance.
Oh, it's the end of the level. Nice. Alright, we're on to the last level.
This is it then. Hopefully Dr. Malensky doesn't know about this entrance, so we'll be able to catch him by surprise.
Don't kill him unless you have to. I want to talk to him.
Well, you better hope it's not me who finds him first then.
Andre is right, Minoko. The time for talking has passed.
The control signal is very strong now. Its source is marked on your scanners.
Why did I think a place called Eden was going to be all like shiny and fancy? Of course, it's a dump.
Follow me.
Locate and destroy source of control signal. So yeah, if anybody's curious what that dialogue was about there, the big bad guy who's making all these mutants, turns out it's Minoko's father. That's why she wants to talk to him. Because she hasn't seen him in many, many years and wants to know why he's turned into a crazy man who's making monsters. Fancy reflections. Ooh. Okay. Yeah. Oh no! Turrets! Huh? That went well. Noco required. Yeah, it all started with the synthetic meat factory. Hey, Victor.
Recharging. Downloading data. Access denied. Access.
I didn't know there was a turret up there. Here, now that we don't have a turret fucking mowing us down? Or is that the path we have to take? Looks like that's the path we're gonna have to take. Alright. Central silo restricted area.
Follow me.
Follow me.
Seesaw. Oh, let's send the robot up there. Different. Bang. You stop that. There's gotta be a switch somewhere to shut off the electricity to let Carter get to that door switch. This brings us back down here.
Recharging.
Oh, you can just interact with the fucking thing. Okay. There we go.
Minoko, you better come and have a look at this.
Follow me. Follow me.
Follow me.
My God, it's my father. He's so young. He must have been trapped in that time dilation field for years.
So, looks like he's not the one we're after all.
Item required. Daddy! Oh, I can't run into the field. Some fucking durable ass windows, what the hell? anything up with anybody, have I? No. 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 Like a hole big enough for a drone to get through? Oh, hold on. Oh, we had to shoot that thing. Okay. God damn it. Where the fuck that was.
I need some assistance.
Oh shit. Hi turret. There's a turret up there.
Initiating regeneration.
Also this vat seems to be like spitting out monsters. Serpentine. Ow. Back here. Indestructible glass doors that are being held together by a little box. Who knows what the hell that was about? I'm going the wrong way.
Follow me.
Follow me.
Foiled by a tiny piece of metal. Alright. Looks like a job for the boogie. Rover, whatever you call it.
Minoko's the technical one.
Downloading data. Access denied. Access granted.
Like the holodeck? Oh shit. There's Lucy. That's Minoko's sister. Also trapped in a time dilation field. Okay. Okay then, now what? I didn't see any switches or anything in there. I saw. Finder. Something there, but. Huh. There's a door, okay. It's apparently not turned on.
Item reverted.
Well, we did open another silo somewhere.
Recharging.
Where's Silo 2 at? She's got like insta-jibbed. What the fuck? Where's the panel that controls the turret? Guess we can just run by.
Follow me. Follow me.
I need some assistance.
How did we even get up there?
Huh.
thing is so awkward to fly because there's no, like, move up command. Yeah, I heard about the weird Fortnite JC Denton thing. I don't get it. I don't really care. There's a simple solution to that problem. It's just don't read YouTube comments, which are like the fucking toilet of the internet anyway. Disabling comments on my videos. I get exactly three kinds of comments on my YouTube videos. I get either people calling me ugly on my webcam. I get people giving me shit for playing something wrong in a playthrough I completed 9 months ago. Why didn't you pick up the blah blah? Like, I played that a fucking year ago. I don't even know what you're talking about. And then once in a blue moon, I'll get a comment where like, hey, this is a cool game. It's cool seeing this. So 2/3 of my comments are completely worthless. To make the same comment. Nice. You're exploiting it too much. Yeah, it's just like... But yeah, it's my favorite on some like long completed thing and it's just like, hey, why didn't you hit this switch or kill this one enemy? And it's like, who gives a shit? It's a completed Let's Play. It's done. I can't act on your advice even if it's good. Like, what? What the fuck are you even talking about? I mean, I barely get comments at all. Dominus, and the ones I get are usually nonsense. But most of my YouTube videos have like 5 views, so it's like whatever. My YouTube channel is just there because I know some people like to watch VODs. and it's easier to watch them there, but my YouTube channel is just a giant big pile of nonsense. I could give less of a shit about it. See in here. Hey, Tabercurn. I mean, I flushed it, so it's sort of beaten. This game is very, very long. We're on the last level now, if it's any consolation. I'm completely and utterly stuck, but we're on the last... What the fuck? Okay, so the reason I'm stuck is because I didn't trigger that fucking scripted weirdness. This open a new path? No. Okay. Shit. I was actually kind of hoping that would open a new path. Yeah, this is a fake bagel short level. Chapter 2 of Baldur's Gate 2, that's a fake big long level, I'm sure. Mary Skelter. I don't know. I'm completely stuck here. Don't worry, I'll find it, man. Project Eden. Like the last level's pretty fucking long, going by the walkthrough here, holy crap. Apparently can open the door in the hologram area?
Follow me.
No, I thought I tried that.
Follow me.
Follow me. Taking the shortcut, apparently.
Follow me.
Okay, I think the walkthrough says go to the C2 arch. I think that's... we went to the wrong one. Okay. Shit that's going down? No. What's going on? Last I saw, they were buying literally everything ever. Oh, there's a turret up here. Oh, this looks like it's gonna be fun. We're doing an AMA on 8chan. What the fuck is 8chan? I know what 4chan is, I've never heard of 8chan. A site for people who got banned from 4chan for child porn. I didn't know it was possible to get banned from 4chan. For anything. Thank you. To confirm it's real. Oh, Jesus. God damn it.
What the hell is this place?
Oh, isn't like 99% of the posts on 4chan anonymous anyway? Like you don't make even make an account? How do you get banned from 4chan? That's such a weird concept to me. IP banned, yeah, I guess.
Follow me.
Hey Toro, yeah, this is my first time playing through this. Down on the Codex was amazing. When he just went scorched earth on fucking the ownership of Obsidian, that was just like, holy shit, dude.
Andre can repair this. I can fix it.
That's all there is, a camera? They made me repair this so I could look at a camera? What? Game, it's so harmless. It's stupid, but it's like whatever. It doesn't come up that often. And it's incredibly easy to do. This is the key for doing. Woo. Around and around. Around we go. Oh, gross. This is gonna be bad. It says game's borked movement momentum system. No, turret! No! No! They're all so slow, what the hell? Yeah, you can go first person. It's really awkward, so it's not really a good way to play the game, but it can help with aiming sometimes.
Follow me. Follow me.
Thank you. There's no real music, Shinori. There's like a little bit of ambience that crops up from time to time, but there's very, very little music in this game. Fuck's sakes! God. Yeah, it seems like Core Design just like having very little music in their games, I guess. Enemy AI in this game. Hit point sponges. Yeah, I was with the whole squad fucking shooting at it. Come on. Yeah, if they could cut the amount of enemies in this game in like half and it would still feel like too much combat. Yeah, the big final hunts. But at least with the Gambit system, you could go make dinner. Don't even need to babysit it. That's one of the great things about the remaster of Final Fantasy XII is it has that like x4 turbo speed option. It's great. 8159. Is that a combination for something?
Access denied.
Oh, come on.
Access denied.
I have lost my ability to do this hacking minigame today.
Access granted.
Hey, it's like a survivor. 7562. Write these numbers we're finding down, apparently. The other one, 815.
I've forgotten about them.
Yeah, you know, our main objective was to rescue these guys. Gabe's completely forgotten about them. How you doing in there? I just assumed that they were turned into monsters and we murdered them at some point in time. Guess not. So what do we need these number codes for? Started with just a simple, like, a street gang attacked a synthetic meat factory, and we were sent in to stop it, and then we started running into weird mutant monsters, and our investigations found that there was, like, a street drug that was turning people into monsters, and then in tracking down the source of the street drug, it turns out that Minoko's father is apparently some kind of crazy genetic scientist who went insane and is making monsters now. We're not quite sure why, though. We still don't know why any of this is happening. Item required. Item for where? Thank you. those are the combinations to these cells. So much you want to bet we're going to release this guy and he's just going to instantly turn into a monster. 7, 5, 6, 2. Rare times Carter actually gets to interview somebody, maybe? It's one of this guy's special abilities is that he can talk to people and get information that other people can't. It's so very rarely used.
Here. This is a madhouse. She killed Peterson just to encourage us to do her repairs. I managed to get this, which may be of use.
Item received. Key card. Now you're just gonna run around in circles?
Follow me.
It's the key card for this thing. Aha. Oh, surprise, surprise. Shockingly, he turned into a fucking monster.
Follow me.
Certainly didn't see that one coming.
Follow me.
The fuck? Whoa, whoa. Here, it's like a rope. I'd like. Apparently, you have dodge rolls. Hey, we learned some new tech fucking 20 some odd hours into the game.
Downloading data. Activated. Disconnecting. Disconnecting.
Walensky's disc. Okay. Wow. Nice picture of Minoko and Lucy there.
Follow me.
$2,000 Samsung folding phones. Wow. I could buy a like top of the line PC for $2,000. Yeah, that's that's almost 3 months of rent right there.
Follow me.
Halt!
Excuse me. Advocating suicide over the choice of a telephone. There's a healthy mentality to have. Puddle, regardless of where I move it.
Warning. Shield energy low.
Okay, yeah, the whole thing's electrocuted. Yeah, my phone is 5 years, 6 years old, I don't know. It's pretty old. But all I ever use my phone for is text messaging, occasionally a phone call, and the web browser. That's all I need my phone to do. Oh, and I use it as an alarm clock, I guess. Yeah, I don't know how much storage my phone has. I never put anything on it. Have no desire to watch Twitch on a tiny little screen. I've never checked my email on my phone, but I barely ever get emails worth reading, so. Yeah, I live in it's a bachelor suite. My whole apartment is barely bigger than what you guys can see on the camera. And it's $800 a month. That comes with utilities at least. So I don't have to pay power and water and heat, etc. Are infinitely respawning enemies now. Come on, game. No, I have to pay for my internet. And because I'm in Canada, it's exuberantly expensive. What am I missing here? My internet's 120 a month, but it's pretty fast. It's like 300 down, 15 up. This. I've never, oh god, I've never been to Europe. I guess there's this whole area that I haven't actually looked at. So what does this do? It's like pouring water on the floor here? Yeah. How does that... What? Water pressure way up. Whoa. What is this? Yeah, I don't know what cable TV prices are. I haven't had cable since I moved out of my parents' place when I was 18, so... Well, there we go. Now this is like a fire hose. Okay. What's the benefit of having what? Why did I put out water is still going, even though we screwed with the water pressure. Yeah, kick a bit would be nice. Yeah, I don't think the TV's gonna survive too long.
Item reverted. Warning, hazardous environment.
This is so baffling. Like, what? There's a bunch of shit we can do and none of it seems to accomplish anything. I don't... Like, I can move this cable, but this whole floor is electrocuted regardless because there's water coming out. I'm screwed with the water pressure. It didn't accomplish anything. And then putting out a fire over here, which doesn't help us any. Yeah, I don't know how the robot's immune to electricity. It doesn't make a lot of sense. Can we turn the water pressure down? Like more? No. It's either super high or off. Low. I mean, this game does take place in the future where we've discovered how to make people friggin' immortal, so I guess having a waterproof robot's not, or an electricity-proof robot's not that out of the realm of possibility. Maybe if I have, like, all the water spraying out here, it'll stop coming out of the one pipe over there. Nope. Water is still coming out here. I'm gonna have to look this up. Because I have no fucking clue. I'm just running around in circles here. What? Where?
Warning. Hazardous environment. confirmed it.
Going to walk through? There's like some kind of circuit I have to pick up with a rover? Where? I haven't seen anywhere that needs a rover. Wow. That was pretty bullshit.
Like a job for Andre. I can repair this.
Weapon power low.
As long as you touch some kind of conductive metal beforehand, you're fine. Static bands are kind of pointless. What did this accomplish? Still sparking. What did this do? What? Oh, there's a button here. There we go. Internal defense statistics. Ride this up. This is probably what moving the wire does. It probably changes which part of the upstairs is electrocuted then. Spawning enemies here is not conducive to me being able to solve anything.
environment.
Kid? He must be pretty young. I was 20, 21 when this came out. Mid-20s, wow. How about I bring the robot up here? This came out in 2001. Yeah. I'm an old man. So what did that? Oh, it shut off the electricity here. Okay, there we go. Well, that's swell. Clusterfuck. Good times. Good times.
Follow me.
Wait, what? Why is... the electricity on. The fuck are you doing? Hold the switch, shithead.
Follow me.
Alright, now we gotta figure out a way to get the robot through. The robot can't pass the bioscan. Oh, that's not good. Oh, that's not good. Oh no, oh no, oh no, no. Okay. That somehow did zero damage. Well, hello. So we have to get out over there. Stupid fan, go away. Okay, that stopped all the fans. Trippy. It's just quicker if we just kill ourselves here. Yeah, it is. It's really good. If you like puzzle games. If you don't like puzzle games, you won't like this. It's not a shooter. It looks like a shooter, but it's not a shooter. But if you like puzzle games, I think this is definitely worth playing. I've enjoyed this more than any of the Tomb Raider games other than the first one, maybe. It's definitely better than 2 and 3. So I guess we need to activate this elevator with the other people. Lufia 2 had lots of good puzzles in it. That's why Lufia 2 is one of my favorite JRPGs.
Andre can repair this.
I can fix it.
Come on. Damn it.
Weapon power low.
Wow. Dude.
Thank you.
Oh, there we go. Hi. And we're reunited. Yay.
I need some assistance.
Follow me. Recharging. 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 Warning. Hazardous environment.
Follow me.
Follow me. Follow me.
Whoa, okay.
Follow me.
So now we're all the way back over here. I thought I hacked that turret already. What the fuck?
Follow me.
I need some assistance.
Recharging.
Minoko should be able to access this.
Downloading data. Activated.
Wait. What?
Where am I?
Hello, sister. I've been waiting to meet you for such a long time.
What?
Why are you doing all this? What do you want with me, Lucy?
I want your body. What else? Mine's a little worse for wear. Daddy tried to fix it, but it didn't work. I tried to make a new one. I think you met some of my attempts, but that didn't work either. You see, you need a good genetic match, and the little girls I use were too different. But you, well, you're my sister. You're as perfect a match for my DNA as I'll ever find.
You want to use my body as a replacement for yours, but I'm your sister.
So? I'd forgotten you even existed until I accessed the UPA computers. I was just after a few technicians to do some repairs. Thought I'd get them from the real meat company after the way they treated Daddy all those years back. Anyway, enough talk. I've things to do. This is a very complicated procedure, you know. It may take days. So apologies now for any discomfort you may feel.
How did we get into this room, even?
Downloading data. Access denied.
I should be able to hack this.
Access denied. Access denied. Access granted. Disconnecting. Access denied. Access denied. Access granted. Disconnecting. Access denied.
A tough one.
Access denied. Access denied. Access granted. Access granted. Activated. Disconnecting. Disconnecting.
Okay, let's talk to her dad. What the fuck is going on?
It was a trap. What the hell's going on?
You tell me. I only just found out Lucy had taken control of the gene splicer. I was trying to disconnect her. So, how come you UPA operatives got here so fast?
It's been 15 years, Malensky. She trapped you in a time dilation field.
15 years? My God. So why are you here?
Because she's been creating monsters using your gene splicer ever since. She has a small army of creatures under her control. What were you thinking giving her access to your machines in the first place?
I didn't. Well, not intentionally. Her condition had deteriorated so far that I had to use my research computers as a life support for her mental faculties. Basically, half her mind was running on the mainframes. Anyway, I recently discovered, I suppose 15 years ago, that she was interfering with my experiments. All the computers are networked, you see, and somehow her mind had expanded across them. She'd learned how to control my gene splicer and everything else down here.
Okay, enough history. The point is Lucy's now got Minoko, and you're gonna help us get her back.
Minoko? My daughter? My God, she's here! Of course I'll help you.
Follow me.
So how come you never worried about Minoko before?
I did. When Minoko got left behind, I was trying to get her back, but I was a fugitive. And getting information on where...
Oops.
So how come you never worried about Minoko before?
I did. When Minoko got left behind, I was trying to get her back, but I was a fugitive. And getting information on where she'd been taken was impossible. I thought when I'd sorted out Lucy, we'd be able to go back above city limits and find her then. But, well, that never happened.
Fuck. Where the fuck are you going?
Follow me.
Where's this idiot going? His 15 years of being frozen in time has like melted his brain.
Follow me.
Daddy, please stop them. Please stop them, Daddy.
No.
I mean, I assume the lead character of Red Dead Redemption sounds like a generic cowboy. My assumption.
Follow me.
Those are the doors I unlocked with the turret with Pinocchio.
What's happening?
Okay.
Downloading data.
Happens if I trigger this. Just instantly die. Okay. BioShock took that mechanic from the game it's a spiritual successor to, System Shock, which predates this game by many, many years. We stopped some of the lasers, but he's still getting blocked at the entrance here. Get the rover underneath. There we go. Thank you. Am I actually gonna kill this thing in the rover? That'd be hilarious. Get him, Rover! Get him! Boo. Oh well. Shit. Lack of a jump button here is kind of... It, the rover can kill monsters. I've killed stuff with it, so it was definitely doing damage. It's just those things are massive fucking hit point sponges. There we go. That still doesn't help me get off of here, though. Drive the rover up there. So, how do we get by here? The robot can't survive the lasers, can it? Oh. Robot does not give a shit about the lasers, okay. Ow! I just get knocked on my ass by a 2-inch tall spider.
Daddy! Where's Daddy?
Here's Minoko.
I don't feel well, Daddy.
So wait, what is the point of all this laser shit? It's like a giant red herring because the robot just fucking walks through it? Where's Tweedle Dipshit going now? What are you doing?
I need some assistance.
What was the point of that? Like all this like Rube Goldberg stuff to block the fucking laser beams. This is like, nah, just walk through it. It's fine.
My head. She was trying to replace my mind. It was horrible. Hello, Dad?
Hello, Minoko. Oh, you look so old.
Wow.
Very nice. It looks like Lucy is in trouble. I suppose we better try and sort her out.
Yes. Yes. That's probably best.
Hey, Lucidius. You look so old. Override units. Oh look, and there's four of them. And there's four of us. Disconnecting. I wonder what we need to do.
Follow me.
Why'd the door shut? Yeah, games either... What the? Oh god, it's the Satan guy! Ah! I forgot about this thing! Oh god, get away. Get away. Turret. A lot. This thing has a lot of hit points, and I can't shoot him when he's point blank because my weapon won't splash damage myself. Okay, just use this. Yeah, some games that people didn't want to watch, some games we had issues with, some games were bad. My turret. My turret's alone. This is the best boss fight of all time. This is so stupid. This thing is like a billion fucking hit points. What the fuck? I guess you could drain like a million ammo clips off of it if you wanted to.
I need some assistance.
Come on, guys. Alright, everybody sit still and fight. And now it's too close for me to use my splash damage. Yay. Core design, why are you so bad at combat? Ow! Ow! And like, death is so completely and utterly inconsequential in this. It's just like, oh no! I'm dead. Just respawn and fight up some more. Yeah, that was tip top, best boss fight ever.
Follow me.
Oh good, more enemies are spawning in. Fuck. Damn it! Fuck.
Follow me.
Are you fucking... Fucking Andre.
No! Don't kill her!
Don't kill her. It's okay. It's over.
What are you planning now, Malinsky?
Oh, you'll see. Just hang on, I need to collect something from my old lab.
Well, looks like you're gonna be a family again, Minoko.
I don't think so. I prefer being an orphan.
No kidding. And I thought my family was weird.
Sure. Yay, we did it. What the fuck was that? Sure. Music sound effects by Martin Iveson. Not much music there, Martin. BJ Samuel Kill. Quite the name. Welcome for playing your very weird video game. There we go.